Assalamualaikum. Hope you all are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to the online platform of NIEPS Home School. I am Devata Basun Fellows, Assistant Teacher of Mathematics, National Indian English Version School, Deshi. Today I will discuss on the topics of multiplication of class 4. My dear students, in our previous lessons we have already learned the process of multiplication. Now, we solve the CBQ question. First, we read out the question. Let's do. The question number is 4. Here, the question is, you put taka 165 a month in a market rate. Question A, taka 165 is equal to how many paisa? Question B, how much money can you save in 1 year? Question C, how much money can you save in 4 years and 5 months? Now we go to the solution. Solution of question A. We know that 1 taka equals 100 paisa. By the unitary method, we can easily solve this question. If 1 taka equals 100 paisa, then we can write 165 taka equals 165 into 100 paisa. That means 60,500 paisa. Now, let's do the multiplication. First, we write down 165. Then multiply it with 100. Here 165 and 100 both are 3-digit numbers. So first of all, we multiply 165 with 0. That is 50 the 0, 60 the 0, and 10 the 0. Then we go to the step 2. Here in step 2, we multiply 165 with 0. There are 0 in 10's place. So we have to put 0 here. Then we multiply 165 with 0. That is 50 the 0, 60 the 0, and 10 the 0. This is our second step. Then we go to the third step. We have multiply 165 with 1. Here 1 in 100 place. As it is in 100 place, so its main value is 100, which is 100 times greater than 1. So we have to put 0 and 0 here, that is bigger. Then we multiply 165 with 1, that is 5 1 the 5, 6 1 the 6, and 1 1 the 1. After that, we adding them. That is 0, 0, 5, 6, and 1, which is our required result, that means 16,500 paisa. Okay. Next, we go to the question B. That is, how much money can you save in 1 year? We already know that 1 year equals 12 months. So, in 1 month, we can save 165 taka. This information is already given in our question, that is 165 taka we can save in a month. For this reason, here we write down, in 1 month we can save 165 taka. Again, by the unitary method, we can easily write down, in 12 months we can save 165 into 12 taka. That means 1980 taka. Let's do the multiplication.
Which is 10 times greater than 1.
So we have to put 0 here. Then multiply 165 with 1, that is 5 1 the 5, 6 1 the 6 and 1 1 the 1. After finishing step 1 and step 2, we add in that. That is 0 plus 0, 0, 5 plus 3, 8, 6 plus 3, 9 and 1. That is 1980, which is our required result. Then we go to the question C. That is, how much money can you save in 4 years and 5 months? Here, we can write 4 years 5 months equal 4 years plus 5 months. We have to convert 4 years into months. And in our question B, we know that 1 year equals 12 months. So we have to multiply 4 with 12. That is 4 into 12 months plus 5 months. 4 into 12, the multiplication result is 48 months plus 5 months. 48 plus 5 equals 53 months. Again, in 1 month we can save 165 taka, which is already given in our question. Then by unitary method we can write in 53 months we can save 165 into 53 taka. The result of multiplication is 8745 taka. Let's do the multiplication again.
Keep well, stay at home. Allah bless. See you later.